Hello students, welcome you back to the course of cloud computing. We are in the fourth unit dealing with cloud resource provisioning. So in the last lecture we saw what it means by resource provisioning. In this lecture we will see little more in detail about the types and the parameters of resource provisioning. So the various parameters that will be included for resource provisioning are response time. So all these by the bolded words, you can very well understand the meaning. Response time is the time taken for us to make a request and get the reply. So the resource provided time. And then the minimize cost. We should always be interested in minimizing the customer cost. And revenue maximization, we already discussed in the last lecture. It is to do with the cloud service provider. And fault tolerant, the algorithm what we are using should be free from failure of nodes, and reduced SLA violation. So we are going for a service level agreement. It should not violate that agreement. So the reduced amount of violation should be there, and reduced power consumption. Although we are not using it in our end, whatever power is being used in the cloud service provider end will also cost us. So that also should be a reduced consumption. So these are the steps in cloud service resource provisioning. So we have to define the workload, provision the cloud resources, establish a connectivity bridge, deploy the workload, and then we'll have to ensure seamless two-way access between the provider and the consumer. Then now and then testing and validating should be there to ensure that things are going okay. And finally, once the service is over, it should discontinue, because we are going for a pay by use. So whenever the service is over, immediately we should be discontinued. So we will see each of these steps in detail. So basically in this diagram, as you can see, I have some text content on the right side, which is explaining the steps, as well as the numbers also put in the diagram. So the very first diagram has application workload and the number one. It means that we are defining the workload. So the workload is initially with the enterprise data center, as it is written there. And we are going to give some request. So the number and type of virtual machines required for migration, all this will be depending on what workload is available in the data center. So I will be making a request. That is the step one. And in step two, we are going to provision the cloud resources. So there is a network here in the data center, and the network in the private or public cloud, both are connected. So whatever is available in the data center is now being provisioned to the public or private cloud. So that is the second step. And this will include all our services, whatever we need, whether it is server, storage or network, and so on. Then coming to the third step, see, the resources have to be sent across. So we have to establish a connectivity bridge. So the third step includes, as you can see in the middle of the diagram, a bridge-like structure is given. So we are securing a transparent bi-directional connectivity, and this is usually done through an internet VPN. And this is required between the data center and the cloud, both for migration as well as any cross-platform application interactions. After migrating, after sending all the resources also, it may require some interactions between. So we need the bridge to be maintained till the entire service is going on. And in the fourth step, we are deploying the workload. So the entire workload from the data center, as you can see in the diagram, the box has been sent to the public and private cloud. So with connectivity in place, all the virtual machines can be configured and connected to the services in the private or public cloud. So we are migrating or shifting the resources to our usage. Then coming to the fifth step, we have to ensure seamless two-way access. So as you can see, The bridge has bidirectional link and smooth interaction is required. So this has to be enhanced through the software that we are using, and we should be able to monitor this particular flow. So the monitoring part will also be done here. So we learnt about the auditor. So actually that role comes to play here. And then in the sixth step, we can see on top, we have a small module called test and validate. So this is also included in the auditor role. So we have to be prepared to test prior to the deployment if everything is transferred correctly. If the network storage and compute and database are configured correctly. So all this has to be whether you can see and manage the cloud environment properly. Whether the cloud backup process is working correctly. So all this has to be tested and validated even before you deploy. So it has to keep doing correctly. Then final step, you discontinue the old service. So once I have migrated, so I have shifted everything to the cloud, then I don't need to have connectivity with my legacy system or my old system. So definitely decommission the enterprise service. Okay. So this is how we go about cloud resource provisioning. So we'll stop here and continue the next lecture, wherein we'll see little more in detail about the type of cloud resource provisioning. Thank you.